Hey there, everybody, and welcome to HD Piano. My name is Dan, and in this lesson, we'll learn how to play I Fall Apart by Post Malone. We'll take a look at the intro and first verse in this first of five videos. Here we go. Ready, and... Verse 1.
She told me that I'm not enough. She left me with a broken heart.
And continuing. Alright, so there's quite a bit there to unpack, but a lot of recycling. You're going to find the rest of this lesson at hdpiano.com if you're not already there. My question for you is about Post Malone. I'd like to know when you discovered him. He kind of broke out into the scene around 2015, and he's just 23 years old now, so I'm really interested about how you discovered him. Was it on Spotify or YouTube or Twitter? Comment below. Middle C is here. We're in the key of G sharp minor. And just as a summary here of what we're learning, this is sort of a reduction of the piano parts, which there are a lot of in the recording, the synth, the guitar, bass, and even some drum-type rhythmic elements throughout. So this is our arrangement, and I think it works really, really well as sort of an instrumental backing track. So find a singer to bring it to life. All right, so we start with just this four-chord progression that I'm going to teach you before we really talk about the pieces. The four chord progression goes like this in its root form and its bass form. You'll never play it like this, but it's easy to teach it this way. C sharp minor, D sharp, E, G sharp. G sharp minor, which is G sharp, B, D sharp. And then E, which is E, G sharp, B. And F sharp major, which is F sharp, A sharp, C sharp. So that's the first four. And then it repeats. But the fourth chord, the second time, is C sharp minor. Okay, so that's the only difference. But otherwise, it's just a repeated four chord progression with just that variation every other measure. So really, if you wanted to take this and make your own cover version, that's all you'd need to know, those four chords, because that's what makes up the entire song. I mean, you could hear me singing when I was playing the actual backing track. Here it is with just the basic chords.
She told me that I'm not enough.
Right.
She left me with a broken heart.
Yeah. All right, so you can get away with just those four chords, but for the rest of this lesson, I'm going to be diving into really the nuances of that backing track. What, you know, Austin... Post Malone was going for in the recording. So here we go, the actual backing track. C sharp minor 7 is our start. C sharp, G sharp in the left, E, B in the right. We're going to reach that pinky up to D sharp and then down to C sharp on the ring. Shift completely to G sharp minor, G sharp, D sharp in the left, B, D sharp in the right. And jump the pinky down to B. Excuse me, stumbling through the keys here. Playing this line here. So the right hand's playing B, B, G sharp, E, and then F sharp, A sharp. Left hand goes up to F sharp and C sharp. Here's those first two measures. Moving on. Now this is almost undoubtedly a computerized piano part, meaning somebody composed it into a computer. They never actually performed it, which is fine. You know, I've got nothing wrong with that. But that makes it a little complicated to play, right? So this is definitely the hardest little passage, and it happens a few times in the song. So it's D, F sharp, E, E, and then we jump up to C sharp and B. And we're not done because we still need to shoot up to D sharp and C there. All right, so that passage, is going to need individual work. So take your time and learn this. All right, and the left hand there is playing that C sharp power. Power is a fifth, by the way, this shape. G sharp fifth. So now we're pretty much continuing as we started, except we finish here on a C sharp minor. So that really makes up the intro. I'm gonna play that whole intro, everything I just sort of walked through, play it super slow for you. Ready, play. This is officially when the vocal comes in, and we've opted for a very subtle part here. There's not much going on. We like to let the voice shine here. And all we're doing here is playing those power chords, C sharp, G sharp, E, F sharp, those powers, and then C sharp, G sharp, E, C sharp. And the rhythm we play with is the same as the intro. One, two, three, four. A little anticipation here. And two, and three, four, and same thing. Two, three, four, anticipate down to C sharp, and three, four, okay? As we move through the verse, we pepper in some more piano. And that's just like the intro. Except instead of shooting up here, we stay low this time. Now, we've got another complicated. Love it. It's D sharp, G sharp, E, B. I like to just kind of set my hand in this general area so that I don't have to jump. And then E up to D sharp. So that's a tough passage as well. Super advanced. And I'm afraid there's no way around it. It's a computer-made part, so we're doing our best to capture that in human hands. Okay, moving through. And the final passage is just like the intro. Okay? So let's actually go right where the vocals come in so that maybe we can track this a little easier. Ready? Play. Sorry, the lyric is, she told me that I'm not enough. Ready? Yeah.
She told me that I'm not enough. She left me with a broken heart. She fooled me.
And then now we're adding right hand. Do that same thing super slow. I'm actually going to skip over the power chords. I feel like that's a bit of a waste of our time. So here we go. This is five measures into the verse, which would be on the line, she fooled me twice. Ready?
She fooled me twice.
Okay, tons of music here. I hope you found little shortcuts within. This is, again, a computerized part that we're doing our best to put into human hands, so forgive any of the challenges and work through them. And that's why we're here, right? That's why we practice. So to finish the lesson, I'm actually going to go from the intro all the way to the end of the first verse. We'll do a super slow-mo, and then we'll do at recorded speed. So here's super slow-mo, intro, and first verse. Ready, end, play, end. Thank you. verse 1.
You told me that I'm not enough.
3, 4.
Left me with the broken heart.
Fooled me twice. Just like that. All right, let's head on over to hdpiano.com to wrap it up. If you are on YouTube, comment below, tell me how you discovered Post Malone. Find us on social media, say hello. Drop your song ideas to requests.hdpiano.com. And that's it. I'm Dan, hdpiano.com, the home of the hybrid piano lesson. I'll see you for part 2.